guys, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, as you guys can see by the title, is a video that you guys have requested from me quite a few times. I've seen a lot of you guys comment here and there on some of my Lemon, who is my Pac-Man Frogs videos, and asking me to make a video of the pros and cons of owning a Pac-Man Frog, because I know that a lot of you are considering getting one, or maybe you have gotten one recently, and you guys were just wanting to know my opinions on the best and worst parts of owning a Pac-Man Frog. So I actually made a complete list of all of the pros and cons, in my opinion, of owning Lemon, who is my Pac-Man Frog. I'm sure you guys are familiar with her. And I will start off by saying my pro list is much longer than my con list. I really love Lemon. I love having her. And in my honest opinion, I actually think Pac-Man Frogs make a really good pet. I actually think that's a pretty popular opinion among reptile and amphibian owners. I think that a lot of people who have had Pac-Man Frogs or who still have them really love them and enjoy them. They really are an enjoyable pet in a weird way. It's kind of hard to explain unless you've actually had one. While they are really inactive and you can't hold them and you really can't do anything with them, they're just a really cool little pet to have. I imagine they would be somewhat similar to how it would be to have fish or snails or something that you really can't hold and play with, but you enjoy feeding and taking care of. I guess it's kind of like a labor of love because you do it, but you don't really get a lot of reward back other than the enjoyment of just having them and being able to watch them. Okay, so we're gonna start first with the pros list. The first thing on my pros list is that she's very easy to maintain. And by this, I mean that her daily care day to day is very simple. She really doesn't require a whole lot of me. So I basically just go in there every night. I check on her, make sure that she's okay. Her tank is very moist, make sure that it's not dry because it does have to stay wet in there for them. I rinse out her water bowl and sometimes I feed her depending on her feeding schedule. So I believe Pac-Man Frogs are very easy to keep alive and maintain as a pet. My second pro on my list is that you don't have to clean the tank very often. Pac-Man Frogs don't make a huge mess. You do have to go in and spot clean, like I said, rinsing out the water bowl, making sure if there's any dead bugs like crickets or anything in there that you want to get those out and make sure they don't rot. But other than that, you really don't have to clean the tank a whole lot. You do obviously got to keep it wet and moist, but I've had her since October, so in 4 months, I've only had to clean her tank one time, and that was just to get all of the substrate out of there because they do, you know, soil the substrate up, and you don't want them to be absorbing that through their skin and getting any of those toxins in their body if they are using the restroom in the soil. Lemon does use the bathroom in her water bowl most of the time, so she's really easy, but she does obviously still go in the soil, so you do have to clean it once every few months, but that's really not that often, as long as you do regular spot cleans. The third pro on my list is that you only have to feed a Pac-Man Frog about 3 to 4 times a week, depending on how old your Pac-Man Frog is and what you're feeding them. So I choose to feed Lemon live, which means I feed her crickets and worms only. Some people choose to feed frozen mice and pinkies and things like that. I choose not to do that. And especially if you don't have an adult Pac-Man, I definitely wouldn't feed a baby a pinky or even like a juvenile a pinky. So for the sake of easy digestion, I do choose to feed Lemon crickets and worms. However, I do not feed her mealworms. I have heard that mealworms can kind of be hard for them to break down, so I've always stayed away from them. But she loves night crawlers and she does love crickets. And she only has to be fed about 10 or so crickets or about 2 worms every 2 days. Sometimes I feed her every other day if she only ate maybe like 4 or 5 large crickets. I'll give her a few more the next day. The fourth pro on my list is that Pac-Man Frogs are really quiet. I have never heard Lemon make any noise, and I've heard that she's a boy. People have told me she's a male. I don't know if there's a difference between males and females in terms of noise, but I've never heard Lemon make a peep. She's very quiet. She's really easy, and yeah, I just have no complaints as far as noise go at all. My fifth pro is that their tanks do not have to be super huge. So Pac-Man Frogs are obviously very immobile. They sit in one spot. They don't really move. So she doesn't need a huge 40-gallon tank or anything like that. Lemon is currently in a 10-gallon aquarium, and I think that that's perfect for her. She doesn't move. She kind of just buries down and sits in one spot. She may change corners of the tank if she's getting too warm. Sometimes she'll go to the cool end or vice versa. But honestly, her 10-gallon is a decent size for her. She's not fully grown yet. I don't know how big she's going to get because, again, I don't know if she's a male or a female. If she is a female, she may double in size, but she's not growing that fast. She's definitely getting fatter, but she's not so much getting bigger. So her 10 gallon seems to be working perfect for her, and she just doesn't take up a whole ton of room, which I actually really like. The next pro on my list is that she has no smell. This is something that I was worried about before I got her. I wasn't sure how her urine or her bowel movements would smell before I got her. I'd never had an amphibian before other than when I was little, but I've never had a Pac-Man frog. So I wasn't sure what to expect as far as smell goes, but I have had her for several months now and I have smelled nothing. Obviously, her bowel movements themselves can have a bit of an odor to them, but I really don't smell them, and I do spot clean her tank about twice a week if I do see anything in there. You shouldn't have any smell in there whatsoever, and if you do, you really need to clean your tank. And the last pro on my list is a very superficial reason to love Pac-Man frogs, but I love all the different colors they come in. I think that she's so bright and beautiful. As you guys know, Lemon is a yellow or albino Pac-Man frog. She is yellow and kind of oranges and has like the orange stripes on her. She's absolutely beautiful, but they also come in lots of other colors. There's teal Pac-Man frogs, which I've never actually seen. You also have your ornates, which are really, really beautiful. I would love to have an ornate one day. I think they're bright green and reds are so pretty. There is also the strawberry color. There are just so many colors to choose from. I'll put a picture on the screen to show you guys, but I love that they come in so many different morphs and things. I think they're beautiful, and I did leave that as the last pro because obviously that shouldn't really be a reason why you get an animal just because it's a pretty color, but all the same, it is definitely a reason why I love Pac-Man frog. Now for the con list, and I will tell you, my con list only has three things on there. There's really only three downsides I feel to owning Lemon. The first is that you can't hold her. Obviously, if you have some reptile safe gloves, then yes, you can hold her and it won't be a big deal, but as far as being able to take her out daily, like say a bird, or being able to pet her like a cat or a dog, it's just not gonna happen. It's not recommended, and I definitely suggest never touching your Pac-Man frog unless you're cleaning out the tank. That's the only time that I ever take Lemon out. I would definitely not recommend getting a Pac-Man frog if you want something that you can hold and interact with. That's really not why I bought her for. I was aware of all of these things going into getting her, so none of this surprises me whatsoever. I made sure to do my research. I also talked to Tara a lot because she had a Pac-Man frog whenever I got Lemon. I was completely aware, but that's always something to remember. The second con on my list is that they do eat live insects. Now, for some people, this may not bother you whatsoever, especially if you already have a bearded dragon or geckos or other things that eat live bugs. Then this is just another pet that eats the same foods you already have. However, for me, I didn't have any pets that ate crickets whenever I got Lemon. She is the only animal that I have that eats actual crickets. So that was definitely an adjustment, and it's definitely the worst part of having her, I would actually say, is the fact that she needs crickets. Crickets suck. They die so fast. They're so loud. And if you have too many of them and you don't clean out their enclosure, they can smell really bad. Luckily, I've got a handle on it. My crickets don't smell. They do make noise, but if I get medium size, they don't make any noise whatsoever because they don't have the wings yet. However, she does prefer the larger crickets. Of course, she is getting bigger. So the large crickets definitely make a lot of noise. If you guys saw my last video, then you definitely know that's true. Also, crickets do die really fast. So I find that I am having to get a new batch of crickets every single weekend to about every 10 days. I get about 36 large crickets and I keep them in a really large cricket keeper, which it works really well. Luckily, they're easy to keep alive. If the weather is too cold in the house, I find that they die a lot faster. If there's too many in an enclosure, they'll die a lot faster. So it really is a balancing act. So I think that I finally figured out how to do it, and I think I could do a whole video on how to keep your crickets alive. I don't know if anyone would be interested in that, but so that's why crickets is definitely a con for me. It sucks, but I know it's necessary, so I don't mind. However, she does eat worms, and I already have worms in my fridge constantly for Koa. Worms are super easy. I feed night crawlers to Koa and Lemon. I always have those readily available. They're available at Walmart in the fishing section. I've had some people ask me that, where I get their worms. But yeah, I just get them from Walmart and they stay alive in the fridge for like months at a time. So it's amazing. I really don't mind the worms at all. And the third con on my list is that they are very aggressive eaters. Now, this actually isn't really a bad thing for some people. If you are not scared of frogs whatsoever and their leap and jump at you doesn't scare you, then this isn't a con. Yes, Lemon does lunge very aggressively and I scream every single time. It doesn't even faze her. But I did put it on the con list because they are really aggressive. So again, that's another reason why you really can't put your hands around them, or you have to be really careful holding them because you can get bit. And while no, it probably won't hurt super bad or anything, I've never been bit, so I can't say. But it is definitely something that I wanted to put on the con list just because I'm sure some people wouldn't like to have a really aggressive pet, and Pac-Mans are very aggressive eaters. And the last thing that I want to mention, in my opinion, it isn't a pro or a con. I think kind of like being an aggressive eater, it depends on who you are as an owner, but it is something to mention. Pac-Man frogs can live up to 10 years, so they're not gonna have the lifespan of a hamster. They're gonna live a lot longer than a couple years like a hamster would. Now, they don't live quite as long as a bird, where they would go into the 20 and 30 year range, but they still do have quite a sizable lifespan, so that is something to remember. If you're 10 years old and you're in elementary school, you know, and you're depending on your parents and things like that, remembering that those crickets have to be bought about every single week, unless you're feeding just worms, which I don't recommend. I do suggest you give them a very varied diet if you can. Lots of different types of bugs and worms, at least, at the very least. And of course, I also give Lemon calcium powder on her crickets and her worms as well. But again, that's something else to just remember. If you are a kid wanting a Pac-Man frog, I would say the fact that you can't hold them, the fact that you do have to make sure that you keep a stock of crickets. With crickets, you do have to feed them every single night. So I make sure to slice up fresh potato every single night. I have to put it in there, and then I actually have to go into the cricket container and I have to take out all of the dead crickets as well. So the cricket maintenance is actually much more taxing than the actual maintenance for the Pac-Man frog, which is crazy. But I spend a lot more time caring for the crickets than I actually do maintaining Lemon, because the crickets are so temperamental and they can die so easily. You have to keep the dead crickets out, keeping them fed and making sure that their enclosure is the right temperature. It's a lot, but it is worth it because I love Lemon. Again, if you're depending on your parents, they're gonna have to make sure to go pick them up for you about every week or at least every other week if you can keep them alive. And the fact that they are pretty aggressive, so if you are a kid, be very careful that you don't get bit, because they do not discriminate on where they dart at. They will just lunge and that's it. They latch on and they don't let go, so that's something to remember. But honestly, other than those three cons, there is like nothing wrong with having a Pac-Man frog. I really love Lemon. Obviously, if you are young and you are not responsible enough to take care of a Pac-Man frog, then please do not get one. So those are some things to consider, good and bad, with owning a Pac-Man frog. Honestly, this is just my opinions, and all of this is just my personal experience from having Lemon since October. But I do hope that this video was helpful to you guys if you're considering getting Pac-Man frog, or you just wanted to learn more about them in general. I hope that this video helped you, and I hope that you enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys don't already follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, or Twitter, I will put that on the screen for you. I will see you guys in my next video. Be kind. Bye.